Here I'm going to solve this by substitution. We're going to let u equal, here the key is the middle term, x to the minus 1 power. So that u squared then would be x to the minus 1 squared or x to the negative 2 power, and that's what we have here. So when I make the substitution, I'd have 3u squared plus 5 times u minus 2 equals 0. So it looks like a regular old quadratic. Let's go ahead and factor that. So 3u squared breaks up as 3u times u. If it doesn't factor, we would use the quadratic formula. Let's factor 2 as 1 times 2. Okay, and I need a 5, so I have a 6u and a 1u. To get a positive 5, the 6 better be positive, and the 1 should be negative. Okay, so that'll give me 5u for my middle term, and then negative 1 times 2 is negative 2, so it's factored correctly. Then set each factor equal to 0. Okay, so u plus 2 could equal 0, or 3u minus 1 could equal 0. Solve each one individually. 3u equals 1. U then could be 1/3, or u could be negative 2. Once you solve for u, remember you're actually solving for x. We have to then back substitute. So u is equal to x to the negative 1 power. And when I back substitute there, we have two equations in terms of x. Okay, so let's solve these. Remember, x to the minus 1 power is really 1 over x. So 1 over x could equal 1/3, or 1 over x could equal negative 2. Well, you can cross multiply or simply reciprocate both sides. X over 1 could then equal 3 over 1, right? Reciprocating both sides. I can do the same thing here and say then x over 1 could equal negative 1/2, or 1 over negative 2 if you want. So here's my two solutions, x equals 3 or x equals negative 1/2. So you could check those, they work. And let me write my solutions in set notation. So the two solutions to the original should be negative 1/2 and 3.